morning, happy Monday, and thank you for joining Hendrik News today. I am Messya Widyatari here, bringing you news from the U.S. President Joe Biden meets his Mexican counterpart, Andres Manuel Lopez Obrador, in an official welcoming ceremony before taking part in the North American Leader Summit in Mexico City on January 9. The Biden administration rolled out additional measures during Tuesday's North American Leader Summit in a desperate bid to keep migrants from journeying to the U.S. southern border. The legislative effort come at a time of unprecedented movement in the Western Hemisphere and are designed to curb border crossing while making programs to legally migrate to the United States, Mexico, and Canada more accessible, according to a senior administration official. Over the course of his presidency, Joe Biden has faced changing migration patterns that pose unique challenges to the administration and have stretched federal and local resources. The issue, in turn, has increasingly become a political vulnerability for the administration, which has drawn fierce criticism from Republicans and Democrats, and been a key point of discussion with partners to the south, primarily Mexico. Following the summit, Biden thanked Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador for stepping up to receive into Mexico those not following the lawful pathways. Leading up to Tuesday's summit, administration officials underscored the need for a regional response that shared the responsibility of stemming the flow of migration among partners in the hemisphere. The Biden administration announced a virtual platform that will serve as a one-stop shop for migrants to find information about legal pathways they might be eligible for, either in the US, Mexico, or Canada, and the opening of a new resource center in southern Mexico, the senior administration official said. We're always in competition with the smugglers, so we think having an easy-to-access, user-friendly field to a platform is really important. But then centers where people can go and they know they can trust the people there and get accurate information and even be referred based on intakes and interviews, the official added. As part of the effort, the U.S. is working with Mexico to open brick-and-mortar centers where migrants can get information about how to apply to migrate to the U.S., mirroring the Migrant Resource Center launched in Guatemala. A new center will be established in Tapachula, a city in southern Mexico, which thousands of migrants pass through on their way to the U.S.-Mexico border. The portal is still being built and may not be unveiled for several months still, so the details are still up in the air. One big factor, experts says, is how the administration would determine whether a person is disqualified from being able to seek asylum in the United States. United Tuesday Summit built on last year's gathering on Los Angeles, where countries across the Western Hemisphere committed to the Los Angeles Declaration on Migration and Protection. The summit was a point of contention between the U.S. and Mexico, when President Andrés Manuel López Obrador snubbed the gathering over disagreements about who was invited. Mexican officials still attended the summit. That is the Hendrik News Morning for this Monday. Thank you for watching. I am Messya Widyatari and have a great day.